QuakeCon Finals Tournament. It's about 4 hours long. It's gonna go on. Where people are going to win, win, win!
Give these people a huge round of applause. Sponsorship, what we have had this year has been incredible. I want to make sure to give a big shout out to Deep Pool Gamerstorm. I want to give a big shout out to Thermal Take. Shannon, he's around here somewhere. Patriot has been a huge supporter in our prize pool. Patriot Viper Products, SSDs and Memories, you guys have won some of that stuff.
Isn't that very
good stuff. Fractal, Enermax, Be Quiet, Inman, Kingston, EK, CPU Magazine, Crucial, EVGA, Gigabyte, Micro Center, and last but not least, Id and Bethesda.
Yeah!
For 24 hours of the mods, I want to make a special shout out to Corsair for providing all of the base line of hardware and NVIDIA GeForce Garage for contributing what they did, huge, huge, making the 24 hours of the mods. Give it up for all these sponsors. These sponsors here make this happen. Dwayne, you want to start off with some awards? Yep, Scratch over here. Ed Bethesda here. Case one there.
We're going to start off with Scratch. So this is a Scratch that was anything to me that someone who's not a traditional case.
This creepy abomination.
Yeah.
Bailey Mullins for the Fifth Element. All right, second place. Drum roll, please. We're going to go with Gary Murphy of Ball, second place. That's going to get first place to Brandon with the white door. All right, so now, real quick, we got the 24 hours on the mods here. We've got first, second, third place teams. I'm not digging into pockets, folks. I am not digging into pockets. No. Yeah, that's how beans get started, folks. It's always innocent until it gets on the internet. All right, so we had three amazing teams, two-person teams that worked for 24 hours, not straight. Eight hours. You know a guy?
You know what's cool about that? Contacted these guys and told them we wanted to work 24 hours on mods. They said yes right away. They didn't ask if there were going to be prizes, if they were going to get any money or anything about it. They already just jumped right in and said, yeah, we'll do it. Just because of the experience, they picked them.
Woo! So we have, alright, so I'm going to introduce Mod Goat here real quick.
Give me.
Alright, and then we've got, this is Team Texas.
Gary Murphy. John Davis.
Alright, and then Team SFN. Those of y'all that have been around QuakeCon for a number of years probably recognize a lot of these faces. But always, somebody wants to know who wins, so here we go. So third place in the 24-hour case mod. Mods. Team Texas with Fallout to get third place. So now we have to figure out who won this beast. Second place with the Doom mod. Yeah, that settles it down. Second place goes to SFN. Mod Go, you guys win the 2016 Pace Mod of the Mods. Give these guys a big round of applause. QuakeCon to show you guys some great builds. Woo! And the rest of you guys, congratulations for bringing your A game. Good job.
Woo! T-Mobile!
We're out. We're trying to move this thing along. We know you guys want to see some more kick-ass stuff that these people have. But we love you. Modern team, by our site. Please support the sponsors that support you.
Woo!
so much that at the time people believed that you had ESPN. Yeah, this is when esports really wasn't even esports. People didn't know what we were trying to do. And this guy pioneered it.
He was childhood. Yay!
Try to take down Fresh Bonds, deny weapons, deny that light to go, deny the rocket launcher as much as possible.
lift as Regal. It's just on a massive roll.
And one thing that's really interesting is that these guys aren't used to dealing with environments like this. They might not feel tested in front of a stage and the pressure that might bring. So that's going to be interesting to see in the continuation of this series. As Ripcord starts to find comfort, taking players down left and right with the other team with the rocket launcher pushing all the way out to the middle there. That is very, very impressive there for Ripcord.
So hard to take, but now we've got Green at least temporarily in charge of Red Armor. It's going to be Kermis with the pickup. Loktar is looking to pick up the next one, and hopefully Kermis can force his way out and get some free frags.
So now it's funny, Green, you actually hold to the key already in Red Armor area on the map. We actually saw Caraway's picking up a couple kills there on the other side of the map, keeping away his opponent's build for the Rickle. They don't really have much armor, they don't have any weapons. Hilton came in without any help there from a teammate.
Here we go. Need some t-shirts in a second.
take that much time for himself, then you can still get a bit of confidence.
He keeps slamming his rail circle, but he's not really getting anything in.
And Rafa might decide to try and follow up this in a very marginal situation because Rafa wants to win this right here and right now. But he just goes straight back in with some rounds on his own. And so Rafa's not in the best state either. So both of these players never in ideal situations. This is ridiculous.
I'm gonna sing a riff off of that one. I don't know how he got on there. worked out.
Oh!
that he still might be able to come to something in this instance. LG coming out. Can he get close to the Eastern Tour? When he takes out left, people are going to call it. It's not over just yet. We've got 60 seconds to go. Red Armour is up.
We have more.